everyone, I'm Laura and this is Go Simply. Today I have a no repeat, no equipment, body weight only indoor walking workout. We're going to do a freestyle warm up and a freestyle kind of cool down, and then we'll have 15 exercises with 15 blocks of walking in between each of those exercises. If this sounds like something you like, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and let's get started. All right, so to warm up for our indoor walking workout, we're just going to start with some shoulder rolls backwards. And then we'll move them forwards. And then we'll move them to big arm circles forwards. And then we'll move them to big arm circles backwards. And then we're just going to roll one hip out to the side and back. And we'll do that a few times. We'll be sure to get the other side. And one more. Okay, and then let's do the opposite side. Get some movement through those hips, get that synovial fluid that's in the joint, nice and lubricated. And let's do one more here. Okay, and then let's take our arms and touch our toes. Moving nice and fluidly, not too quickly. We don't want to strain the back. We'll do a few more. One more. Then we're going to keep our hands down on the mat. We're going to move our legs back to a plank, and we're going to do sort of a walking plank and twist and do a nice big opening through our hip here. If you need to put your knee down, that's just fine. You can put your knee down and it would look like this. That's just fine. You're still getting the nice opening. We're just warming up. We'll do one more each side. So we're doing all nice fluid movements here. And then you can pull the other leg up. And we're going to see if we can squat down and then come to stand. And squat and stand. We always feel like we can't make our knees bend, and sometimes we really can't, but we do need to keep in mind that a deep bend isn't necessarily hard on the joints, because the quads, the hamstrings, and the glutes get all activated to support the knee joint. And I do have some weight in my hands here. They're not just resting. I am sort of pushing up a bit with that. Okay, and now I'm just going to rotate so that you can see me, and I'm just going to touch one side and stand, and the other side, stand. And again, not twisting too quickly, just getting that spine nice and warmed up. And we'll do one more each side. And then since our legs are out nice and wide, let's just lean off to one side and then the other. And just sort of moving fluidly right through the center. We'll do one more each side. Okay, and then you can sort of toe heel your feet back in. And let's do some knee holds up and really stretch through here. How about one more each side? All right. I think we're nice and warmed up now. I'm going to go hit start on my timer and we'll begin walking. Okay, everyone. Like we always do with our indoor walking workouts, we're going to start with 30 seconds of walking. So you can march on the spot, you can move around your room, you can go, I always put some backwards walking in. I think I tell you in just about every video that we don't walk backwards very often. So it's a really good thing to do. Up next, we are going to do a squat walk. So I'm going to move back so I have some space. So we're going to get down low and we're going to squat walk forwards and stay low the whole time and squat walk backwards. And we're just going to do this for 30 seconds. Get those quads fired up, get them burning. Back to walking. So again, 30 seconds of walking. You can march in place, you can move around, whatever works for you. I will try to let you know with a few seconds to go what the next move is so you can be prepared. So I'll let you know that next up we have push-ups. You can do them either from your knees or from your toes. So we're just going to get down on the ground here, and you can, like I said, you can do them from your toes if you wish. Make sure that your belly's pulled in tight and your back is not arched or sticking up, or you can drop down to your knees and do them from your knees. And again, you want that belly nice tight so your whole pelvic girdle is supported and the lower back is protected. Sometimes I can get better range of motion when I stay on my knees. Excellent. And now we're back to walking. So another 30 seconds. I love these indoor walking workouts because they go so quickly. So you're always coming back to the walking. You always know that the one exercise is going to be walking and then something in between. And all of the ones in between, we're only doing them once. So if you don't like it, you only have to do it one time. Next up, we have reverse lunges. Just going to switch to that reverse lunge. You can do what you wish with your hands. If you want to just leave them on your hips, you can do that. If you need them out to the side for a bit of balance, that's fine too. Or you could hold on to a chair. And sometimes if I want my heart rate to get up more, I move my arms up above my head. And that just gets the heart rate going up because we're moving more body parts and therefore working more muscles. And back to walking. A lot of these indoor walking workouts are always good as well if you're ever traveling in a hotel and you don't have a lot of space to do like big cardio moves. It's pretty hard to jump side to side if all you have is a little space at the foot of the bed. Okay, and next up we're going to do a paddler twist. So we're going to get down on the ground here. So you can just go down and get there now. And we're going to be like we're paddling in our kayak. So you're just sort of scooping from side to side and lean back with each scoop. So really engage those abdominals to protect that lower back. Just like we're on the water. Okay, we're going to go back up and do our walking again. Now, the next move is going to be jumping jacks, and I'm going to show you two versions. I'm going to show you jumping jacks, where you're actually jumping, and then I'm going to show you a version where you don't have to jump. Okay, where pretty much every exercise out there can be modified to take out the jumping portion if that doesn't work for you, and it's still excellent for the body to do that way. So you can do your traditional jumping jacks like this, and that's great. It'll really get the heart rate up. Make sure you move those arms, move those legs, nice big range of motion. Or you can tap out to the side. And that takes any jarring off the spine, if you have sort of any arthritis in the spine or injury, and your heart rate is still going to go up. It's a cardio move. You still move quickly. Okay, and back to walking. So next up, we're going to be down on the ground again. And we're going to do a side plank on the left side. We're going to do the next two moves are going to be on the left side, and then we'll repeat them on the right. I will do the other side, so it really doesn't matter which side you start with. We will do both. I'm going to start on the left if you want to start with me. So we're going to come down to the ground. We're going to do a side plank. You can do it full, all the way from your toes, if that works for you, a nice long tight line. But you can also go from one knee, and that's just, or you can put both knees in, and that's just fine. Okay, and if you can, then up on your feet. So just a few more seconds, then we're going back to walking. So take your time to get up. You don't have to rush. You don't have to jump. A few seconds is just fine. So again, you can move around. You can add in some backwards movement. I have the door open in case my kitties want to come in, and they're sitting right at the door, peeking in, but they seem a little bit shy today. And that's okay. It's a sunny day, so they want to be in the sunbeams. So now we're going to, I forgot to tell you, side lunge to the left. So again, we will do both that plank and the lunge on the right side in the next two exercises. So we will get them done. Now, if coming down like this is too much to come back up again, you can just come to standing like this, and that's fine too. Okay, and back to walking. I'm gonna move around a bit on this one because why not? You can sort of scooch around. And you can stand in one place. You can march sideways this way. And then back and get some lateral movement through those hips. And change it up. Do whatever sort of feels right to you. So now I'm gonna come down and I'm gonna do that plank on the other side. And again, you can go full all the way from your toes. But if you're not feeling it today or that's not working for you, don't quit. Go down to the knees like this. It doesn't matter. And you never know. You might get halfway through it and go, oh, you know what? I can do it. And then try pushing up. Anything to keep you moving. If it means, okay, back up to walking. If it means modifying the workout for today or for a whole week, as long, just get up and do what you can. You will feel better even if it's not, you know, the highest impact or the longest workout, or it's not really what working out is about. It's about doing what you can do on that day. And some days we just don't feel it, and that's fine. But if you let yourself get in a rut where you do nothing, that's when it's hard. Okay, so again, that side lunge to the right. And you can come all the way up. But if that sort of impact on the knee there, the whole body weight coming down is too much, then you can just lean out and come back. So you need to do what's motivating for you on that particular day to keep yourself moving. Okay, and back to walking. So anything is better than nothing. With exercise, anything. 2 minutes is better than no minutes. So if that's what you've got today, then do that and say, you know what, I did something, and tomorrow I'll try and do more. And we have to work on that philosophy, or else we just get so hard on ourselves that we give up completely. And that's not where we want to be. Okay, next we're down on the ground doing a frog crunch. So we're going to have our legs up, knees out, and we're going to crunch and then stretch them out. Now this can be challenging on the lower back, so there are some modifications for sure. You can put one leg down and crunch and then switch, and you're still getting one leg up, and if that's still too much, then just crunch. Okay, and back to walking. So again, lots of options. I will always try to tell you other options. And feel free to do what works for you. You might be able to do the hardest version on some of them, and then need the easiest on the others. I'm definitely like that. So next we're going to get down and we're going to do a plank from our forearms and we're going to body saw. So we're going to sort of slide forwards and back. So I'll show you what I mean here. We're down and we're going to sort of saw forwards and back and just sort of slide through the motion. Now, if it's too much from your toes, you don't have as much range of motion on your knees and your bum's going to come up as you do it, but that's okay. You do what is working for you today. Excellent. And then we'll come back to walking. We only have a couple more to go. Let me see. I have them written down in front of me. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. So, again, really move those arms. Really move those legs. You can try and get those legs up higher if you want. Move around, add in some backwards, my favorite. And now we're gonna do a squat. So just a body weight squat, really pushing that bum out behind you. And keep in mind that the lower we go, there's more supporting muscles working, so there's less pressure on our knees. I know that seems counterintuitive, but really you're working the hamstrings and you're squeezing those glutes, and they're supporting the knees. Okay, and walking again. I got my daughter onto walking workouts too. She loves to walk. And she wants to exercise. I mean, she's not very old yet. She's only 12, but she wants to. And so, but she doesn't love it. She's like, but I don't really like it, but I want to do it. So I got her trying some of these walking workouts and she's like, it's great because I only have to do it for 30 seconds and then I'm doing the walking, which I like again. Okay, and now we're gonna do a side knee with a crunch. Just crunching from side to side, trying to get those obliques, the muscles all through the side here, bringing sort of that bottom rib towards the hip bone is what you're thinking. Just a few more seconds and then we're going to go back to the walking. Excellent. So next we're going to do, some people call it an inchworm or a walkout, and I'm going to show you two versions again. If you can do the full walkout, definitely do it. But if that's not something, I'll show you the not full version first on this one, because it's definitely going to take some lower back stability to do this one safely. Okay, so you can just touch your toes and then reach up to the ceiling, and that's fine. Okay, I'm just giving myself some more room. If you can walk out, you're going to hands to the ground, walk all the way out to a full plank, walk back, and stand. You can't fit very many in because they take a while to do. Whoops. And there. So we only got two in, but it is very good for the spine. It's a good spine mobility. But if you have a sore back, then best to stick with just the toe touches. Okay, so I think this is our last walking and then one exercise left. And then we'll have a cool down. Hopefully I'm right and I didn't mislead you. Okay, so we're going to do toe touch kicks. So I'll show you from the side. So you're just reaching over and trying to get those toes. If you can't reach your toe, that's fine. Just reach where you can. And if doing the long lever of your leg is too much, then do the knee and still reach out. Okay, that's fine. And then if you're feeling it, try and do the whole leg. Excellent. So let's just move right into a cool down. You can just keep moving side to side. Roll those shoulders. We don't want to stop right away. We want to let that heart rate come down a little bit. So just roll them through. Roll them the other way. There, let them loosen up. You can do a few swings across the body and just keep moving those feet as you do it. We're just going side to side. And I'm crossing one arm over the top and then the other, if you can remember to switch. If you can't, that's okay too. Okay. And let's just do a few very controlled swings to protect that lower back. Good. One more here. And then let's come back to the front here. Let's separate our legs a bit and just twist to one side a little bit, and then the other side a little bit. Just get a little bit of extra sort of stretch through the back there. Okay, sort of just roll yourself up and come to standing. Now that our heart rate's up a bit, or down a bit, we can stretch out our hip flexors. They're the ones that always need it the most, sort of rolling that hip through and trying to make a straight line through the hip flexor here, and mine is very tight. Wow. Our hip flexors get tight so easily when we're just sitting. And we tend to sit a lot, right? You know, you sit when you're eating meals, you sit when you're watching TV, you sit when you're on your computer. So we definitely need to stretch them out. Okay, and then we can switch legs, just put the other one, and again, roll it forward, flat across the front of the thigh through the hip there. You should be able to lie your hand flat, right on the front of that hip there. That's what we're aiming for by curling that bum under. Excellent. And then let's do a hamstring. So I'm just going to put this one leg out in front and bend over and pull my toe up. You can even grab it with your fingers if you want. Good. And then we'll just switch sides. Getting a bit of an arm stretch out of it as well, actually, through the upper back and the shoulders there. Excellent. And then let's just do a quick arm cross stretch. We'll add that in for a little bit. This isn't a super long cool down. Feel free to keep going and add more stretching. That would be just fine. Keep going if you wish. And then I'm just going to loop my hands behind me, stretch out my chest. I'm just sort of swaying my hips side to side because it feels good. You can add that if you wish, but you don't have to. And then I'm going to push them out in front and get that upper back again. All right, excellent job, everybody. Thank you for joining me for this indoor walking workout. Grab your friends next time, see if they want to subscribe and join our Go Simply community, and I'll be sure to post again soon. Thanks.